I love the color. If you know me, my favorite color is green. Hey everybody. In this video, I'm going to look at a fountain pen that I recently purchased. It was made by Dryden Designs. I'm looking at their website, and interestingly enough, I don't see the model on here that I purchased, which is strange. When I scroll this, it makes a nice sound, and I can feel it. Each little click, I can something inside my phone makes it so I can feel it. So on their website, all I see are a couple of different pens, and the one that I purchased is neither of them. So I'm not sure what's up with that. This is a 962 Porsche. It's a Group C GTP car back from the 1980s. These cars had, well, they had about 800 horsepower. I'm not sure what the top speed was. The engine was a flat six. Six cylinders, kind of a flat pancake-like design. But back to the pen. So I purchased it off of eBay. No, I'm sorry, Amazon. And it came in this bag. Also in the bag was this piece of paper. And this piece. Which appears to be a feed, a nib, a section, and a ink converter. It appears to be an international converter. Instead of a screw. To make the piston. Let me see if I can zoom in on this a little bit. It's just got a slide mechanism. I've actually never seen one like this. The little ball inside of there is an agitator. I guess it just kind of keeps the ink agitated. I'm not sure why they sent this. The pen itself comes in this nice little case. I'm drawing a blank on the material, I'm sorry. As you can see, it's green. I really do like the color of this. You see, the pen came with a nib, a feed, a section, and a converter. So I was surprised to see two of them. I'm not sure what to say about this this brand. I had never heard of them, and I just stumbled across the pen while I was just kind of browsing Amazon. I thought maybe we would ink it and to see how it does. I don't know much about the company. And if the pen writes well, and maybe I'll do a video, a little bit more detailed video, more information on the company, perhaps. I've got this nice J. Herbin green ink. I thought I would use this ink in the pen. before I do anything else, I'm gonna move the 962 out of the way, just in case there's a bad accident. I have a napkin to kind of blot the excess ink away from the nib. Once we fill it, we'll just kind of do this number here. I'm going to start with a piston. You see the piston? All the way up. And after I dip the pen up to about here, I'll push the piston down, forcing the air out of the converter, and then I'll bring the piston back up, drawing in ink as it comes along. Piston down, piston up, and you can see that it has drawn ink into the converter. Now it's about halfway. Maybe I can fit a little bit more in by repeating this process. Piston down and piston up. Now you can see that repeating the process did add a significant amount of ink compared to what we did have. Now, before I do anything else, I'm going to put the cap back onto the ink. We don't want to spill the ink. If you spill a bottle of fountain pen ink, it will ruin your day. We don't want that to happen. This pen was very inexpensive. Sadly, I don't remember how much it was. So I'm going to flash the price onto the screen right about now. this section of the pin is called the barrel. So let's screw that back on. And let's put the cap on. Let's grab some fountain pen friendly paper. This paper is Clairefontaine. I was looking for a weight. Oh, it's 90 gram. So the nib on this pen is supposed to be a fine nib. Let's post it. Posting means putting the cap onto the barrel. That's posted. And that's unposted or not posted. So let's zoom in a little bit here. Adjust the focus. It's not too bad. There isn't any sort of, I know the brand is Dryden Designs, but there's no model number. The package only says slim, fine nib. Luxury fountain pen, green. I think I had read somewhere that they don't really designate their pens with any particular model. Now, it seems pretty smooth, but it also seems pretty dry. Sometimes after you fill a fountain pen, the more you write with it, the wetter it will get. And what I mean by that is dry, when it's a fountain pen is writing dry, that means it's not laying down very much ink. If I make a mark and drag my finger across it, you can see the distance is only like from here to here. So obviously the more ink that is on the paper, you see that time it went just a little bit further. So maybe it'll write wetter and wetter as I go. actually does feel like it's starting to flow just a little bit better. You know, so far, I'm really liking this. The pen is a slim. I usually write with pens that are a little bit wider than this. Let me reach over and grab the Jinhao 959. You see the difference in size. Now, flex-wise, there doesn't really seem to be any flex to the nib. But it is very smooth. You know, I'll say it again, I really do like this. Now, if there's one thing that I don't like, some people hold their pens, they put their fingers way down here, close to the nib. I'm not one of those people. I put my fingers way up here. I don't know why. That's just what I do. Boy, is it smooth. Let's see if it skips. it seems to keep up pretty good. When I say that, it seems to keep up. That means that the ink is able to come out fast enough to match the speed at which I am writing. I feel like I have very precise control with this pen. And the ink flow seems to be well regulated. Perhaps it's not going to be any wetter than what it is now. But I'm certainly going to put this pen through its paces in the next, for the next 2 or 3 weeks. I'm going to be doing a lot of writing, and I'm going to be writing on various types of paper, and I'm going to report back on this pen, as I mentioned. I've never heard of this brand. I don't know much about the company. If you are with Dryden Pens and you want to send me some information, you can send it to me at this email address on my YouTube channel. I love the color. If you know me, my favorite color is green. Let's see how much this pen weighs. .9 ounces. Now, the pen, it's light. I do have pens that are lighter than this. It's not heavy compared to, I don't know, this Dragon pen, which is a chunk of metal. Weighs 3.6 ounces. But this Jinhao X450, which is one of my favorite pens to write with, weighs 1.5 ounces. Didn't have to push the button. It has an automatic shut-off feature. Thousandths of an inch thick. Maybe 419, 420 thicket cap. And the overall length. Inches 410, let's just call it 5.4 inches. It doesn't seem to show fingerprints at all. There you have it, a Dryden Designs slim, fine nib, luxury fountain pen. And I'll put it through its a workout and I'll get back with you on it. Very smooth, at least on this paper. We'll see how it does on other paper. We'll bring the 962 back into the shot. Thanks for watching.